So we are now going to continue our discussions on the basic issues, basic aspects of the networking in Internet of Things. So we have already seen the different fundamental issues that are out there. Now we are going to look at the different protocols that are there that can be used for serving different purposes in IoT. Now, so based on the different functionalities, there are actually large number of protocols that are proposed for use in IoT. So based on the functionality, these protocols are classified in this manner. So this is just a classification that has been shown, but this is not a unique classification in any way, and it should not be construed in that manner. So this is just a classification attempt under different categories that is shown. And here, as we can see, the different protocols for serving these classifiers, different issues are also mentioned in brackets like this. And so it is basically not possible and also not required to go through all these different protocols. So we have selected only a few protocols from this red colored category, and this is what we are going to discuss in this particular course. So we'll start with the MQTT protocol first. And this MQTT, the full form of this is message queue telemetry transport. So it's an ISO standard which is based on the publish subscribe model. And so basically, what happens is there is some kind of publishing of the data and then the fetching of the data by the subscribers. So this is how this publish subscribe model works. And MQTT, basically what it has done is this publish subscribe model, it has been made lightweight through the use of this protocol, and so that this lightweight protocol can be used in conjunction with the TCP/IP protocol suite. This is what MQTT supports. MQTT, going back to the history, was introduced in 1999 by IBM and is standardized in 2013 by OSIS. This is a standardization organization, OSIS. So it has standardized in the year 2013. So this particular protocol does couple of things. One is offering connectivity between different embedded devices, between the applications and the middleware of one device, and network and communication on the other side of the device. So we have connectivity between applications and middleware for one side and the networks and communication on the other. This is what MQTT does. So in MQTT, there are a few concepts that are involved. The first we are going to go through is the concept of a message broker. And first we are going to go through some of these concepts, and thereafter I am going to show you pictorially how MQTT functions. So we have a message broker, the concept of a message broker that basically serves like a broker which takes control of publishing of the messages and subscription of the messages. So publish subscribe is basically controlled by the message broker, number one. Number two is there is a concept of topic. And this is what the client is subscribed, and based on the updates, the data are sent to the clients by the message broker. This data are distributed by the message broker to the clients who have subscribed to these services. So this is designed for remote connections, limited bandwidth environments, and MQTT, basically the advantage is that it provides a very small code footprint. So basically, by writing only a very small piece of code, one would be able to achieve all these different functions that I have just mentioned. There are different components of MQTT are as follows. We have three principal components: the publishers, which involve the different sensors, the subscribers, that means those entities, those applications, those units that are interested in the data that is published by the sensors. Number three is the broker in between, which helps the publishers and the subscribers connect to one another and also help in classifying the sensor data into different topics. In MQTT, there are a few different methods. One is connect, the second is disconnect, subscribe, unsubscribe, and publish. So, basically, the connect method helps to connect with the server, helps to connect this device with the server. Then the disconnect is the opposite. Whenever it is no longer required to remain connected, the disconnect method helps in disconnecting from the server, from the TCP/IP service offerings, and so on. And then comes the subscribe, which is basically subscribing to the services, and unsubscribe is the opposite. Whenever it is no longer required to continue with getting the different data offerings, the data services, and so on, the unsubscribe method can be executed. And then we have the publish method, which is basically publishing the data publishing the data from these different sensors or these different end devices to the broker for it to be fetched by the different application clients. So, this is what I was referring to just a short while back. So, what we have is this pictorial depiction of how this publish subscribe model works in the case of MQTT. So, we have a temperature sensor, we have laptops, we have mobile devices. This temperature sensor in this example publishes the temperature, which is basically brokered at this MQTT broker. So, what this fellow does is it brokers, because it is a broker between the different clients and the different other application serving devices, which require the data, which can subscribe to the data that is published by these different sensors. So, what it is going to do is, first it is going to get the subscription requests from these different clients, the mobile device, the laptop, and so on and so forth. So, first is the subscribe, and thereafter it is published. So, what is published? The temperature is published. Where is the temperature residing? It is fetched from the sensor and it is being brokered at the MQTT broker. So, from this, those devices, those clients which have basically subscribed to the services, they are going to get this sensing updates, the sensor data updates. So, when we look at the communication, the architecture that is followed is the publish subscribe architecture, and not the request response architecture that is typically followed by traditional HTTP, which is used for the internet. This publish subscribe model is event driven. So, that means whenever there is an event, whenever there is a fire, when the temperature increases, whenever a camera, maybe an IoT camera, basically observes some kind of change in the environment, or whatever, maybe there is an intruder or whatever it is. So, the central communication point, so what we have is, it is event driven. So, whenever there is some kind of an event, and those data are basically pushed to the clients. So, these messages basically are pushed to the clients, and then we have this broker, which is in charge of dispatching all the messages between the senders and the receivers. And each client that publishes a message to the broker includes a topic into the message, and this is that topic which is very much important in the case of MQTT, and this is the topic which is of interest to these application clients. So, each client that wants to receive the messages subscribes to a certain topic, and the broker delivers all the messages within the matching topic in the client to the client. So essentially what is happening is the clients, they do not have to know each other, and what is required is they only need to communicate with each other over the topic. So they do not want to know about each other. And this architecture basically appears to be a scalable architecture with a scalable solution. There is not much dependency between the producers and the consumers of the data, and that is where MQTT is very popular. In MQTT, we have the concept of the topic, as I just mentioned a minute back, and this topic is nothing but a simple string that can have more hierarchical levels, which are separated by a slash in this manner. A sample topic for sending the temperature data of the living room could be marked in this manner, could be named in this manner. So we have house in a smart house kind of scenario. We have house, within the house we have a living room, and the temperature that is collected from this particular living room is of interest. So this is this topic that is of interest, and this is a sample, this is an example of how the topic for sending temperature data of a living room looks like. So one hand, the client, like a mobile device, a laptop or whatever, can subscribe to the exact topic, or on the other hand it can also use a wildcard. So this is an example of an exact topic. Wildcard could also be used. Wildcards can be used in different ways based on the different levels. The subscription to house /+/temperature results in all messages sent to the previously mentioned topic, house, living room, temperature, as well as any topic with an arbitrary value in the place of a living room, such as house, kitchen and temperature. So basically this plus sign is a wildcard character, which only allows arbitrary values for one hierarchy. If more than one hierarchical level is required, the multi-level wildcard is used. So this is single level wildcard, the plus one is a single level wildcard, and this hash sign is a multi-level wildcard. It allows to subscribe to all underlying hierarchical levels, for example house /hash is for subscribing to all topics beginning with house. Different applications that use MQTT: Facebook Messenger for online chat, Amazon Web Services use Amazon IT with MQTT, Microsoft Azure IoT Hub uses MQTT as its main protocol for telemetry messages, the Everything IoT platform uses MQTT as an M2M protocol for connecting several products and devices, Adafruit uses MQTT cloud service for IoT experimenters called Adafruit IO. Finally, after understood the overall philosophy behind MQTT, let us now quickly review the secured version of MQTT, which is called the secure MQTT, the secure MQTT or SMQTT in short. So this is known in both these ways, and this actually to me is quite similar in notion to HTTP and HTTPS, the secure HTTP. So we have HTTP secure HTTP, we have MQTT secure MQTT. So secure MQTT is an extension of MQTT. So basically it's an extension of the MQTT that we just discussed, by using different security features such as encryption and so on. The advantage of such encryption is the broadcast encryption feature, in which one message is encrypted and delivered to multiple other nodes, which is quite common in IoT applications. In general, the algorithm consists of four main stages: the setup stage, the encryption stage, the publish stage and the decryption stage. So setup, encryption, publish and decryption. In the setup phase, the subscribers and the publishers register themselves to the broker and get a master secret key according to the developer's choice of key generation algorithm. So depending on what key generation algorithm is used, the subscribers and the publishers register themselves to the broker and get a master secret key according to that particular algorithm. So when the data is published, it is encrypted and published by the broker, which sends it to the subscribers, which is finally decrypted at the subscriber end, having the same master secret key. The key generation and encryption algorithms are not standardized. SMQTT is proposed only to enhance the security aspects of MQTT. So, in this part of the lecture on basic topics on IoT networks, what we have done is primarily we have gone through two protocols. We have seen that there is an assortment of different protocols that are there to support the networking of IoT, but in this particular part of the lecture we have focused mostly on two protocols. One is the SMTT and the other one is MQTT and the other one is SMQTT, so which is basically the secured version of MQTT. So we are going to go through few other protocols in the next lecture, and from that we can use them finally to establish, to build different platforms for IoT in the small scale or even in the larger scale. Thank you.